Здравствуйте! Hello and welcome to Russian language class. Before moving on, let's have a quick recap of the topics we learned in the previous lesson. If you remember that in the previous lesson, we discussed about the verbs of motion with prefixes. And how many prefixes we discussed so far? We discussed the prefixes were, we, pat, at, pre, and u. Va and we, these prefixes have antonymous meanings. For example, ya vashol v komnatu. In the first example, we have used the verb of motion ichi with the prefix va. Ya vashol v komnatu. It means I entered into the room. So here, va prefix gives the meaning to enter, to go in. But when we add the prefix vi, it gives us the meaning of coming out of a place. For example, ya vishal is komnati. Ya vishal is komnati. I came out of the room. And the question that this sentence answer is kuda and atkuda. Kuda is to where and atkuda is from where. So when we answer kuda, we are using the prefix va to get into, and when we answer the question atkuda, we use vi. Similarly, we have another set of prefixes pad and at. Pad means to approach towards something and at to move away from something. For example, prepadavachal padashulk daske. Prepadavachal padashulk daske. Prepadavachal, the teacher, approach towards the blackboard. So here pad, padashol, or the prefix pad, when it is used with a verb of motion, it takes ka chimu. Ka is a preposition and it takes the dative case of the noun. So prepadavachal padashol kdaske and at prepadavachal atashol at daski. So here atashol takes the preposition at and then the genitive case of the noun which is used after this preposition. Atashol at daski, the teacher moved away from the board. Another set of prefixes that we studied in the previous lesson was pre and u. Pre gives us the meaning to arrive, to reach somewhere or some place, and u to leave some place. Again, these prefixes have antonymous meanings. For example, studenti priyekhali universitet. Studenti priyekhali universitet. The students reached the university. So here, as you can see, pre means to reach or to arrive. And the question it answers is kuda. Priyekhali kuda? And the answer would be universitet. And from the prefix u, we have an example. Studenti uyekhali is universitieta. The students left the university. And again, as you can see, uyekhach is used with the preposition is and then genitive case of the noun, which is followed. And we have discussed when we answer kuda, we use the prepositions va and na plus the accusative case of the noun. And when we answer atkuda, we use the prepositions is or sa with the genitive case of the noun. So, this is all about the verbs of motion with prefixes. So, let's move on to the topics that we will be learning today. We will be discussing today the comparative degree of adjectives and adverbs. I hope you must have heard about what is comparative degree of adjectives and adverbs while studying this term in the other languages. So, let's start. The comparative degree of adjectives and adverbs are mainly derived from the qualitative adjectives or adverbs. Why? Because two objects can be compared only on the basis of the quality they possess. So, that is why we derive the comparative degree of adjectives and adverbs from the qualitative adjectives or adverbs. So, now the question is, how do we form the comparative degree of adjectives and adverbs? The first rule that we follow while forming the comparative degree is by adding the suffix ye, ye. It's double ye. So, mainly the comparative degree of adjectives are formed by adding the suffix ye, ye. And the first ye is invariably stressed in the comparative degree. So, let us look at the examples. The first adjective I have written here is krasivi. What is krasivi? It means beautiful. Krasivi, this is an adjective. Krasiva, this is an adverb. And from these adjectives and adverb, we derive the comparative degree, which is krasivye. So, what we have done? We have removed the ending and added the suffix ye and ye to the stem. So, this is how we derive a comparative degree of an adjective or adverb. So, krasivi, adjective, krasiva, adverb, and krasivye. Krasivye is the comparative degree. The next is khalodni. What is khalodni? Khalodni is cold. Kholadna, adverb. So, khalodni is an adjective. Kholadna is the adverb. And khaladnye is the comparative degree derived from these two, adjective and adverb. The next example we have is interesni. Interesni is interesting. Interesni is an adjective. Interesna is an adverb. And what do we derive? So, what comparative degree do we form from this adjective or this adverb? We again do the same thing. We drop the ending and add the suffix yeye. Interesne is the comparative degree derived from the adjective interesni or the adverb interesna. The next example we have is bystri. Bystri is fast. So, this is the adjective. Bystra, this is the adverb. And what comparative degree do we form from either this adjective or this adverb? Bystrie, again we are adding the suffix ye. So, this is how we form the comparative degree. So, this was the main rule that we follow while forming the comparative degree from either an adjective or an adverb. So, there are a couple of more rules also that we will be looking after this point. We are now talking about the formation of comparative degree from the qualitative adjectives or adverbs. The first rule we have already discussed. The second rule is, if the adjective or an adverb ends with either of these consonants, which are those consonants? K, G, H, D, T or ST, then what happens? We add the suffix ye at the end with some alternation in the consonants. So, what happens is, these consonants may be altered, and that is how we get the comparative degree of the adjectives or adverb. For example, the first alternation that takes place while forming the comparative degree is ka changes to ch. For example, yarki. Yarki is an adjective which means bright. Yarka, which is again an adverb derived from the adjective yarki. So, yarki and yarka, so these two words have k ending stems. So, their stem ends with the consonant k. So, what happens when we form their comparative degree? We change this k with ch. So, yarche and add the suffix ye. So, this is how we get the comparative degree. So, yarki, you drop the ending which is e and e kratke and change this consonant k into ch, and we get the comparative degree, which is yarche. So yarki, yarka, and yarche. The next is gromki. Gromki is loud. This is an adjective. Gromka. This is the adverb derived from this adjective. So gromki, gromka. So how do we form the comparative degree? We drop the ending, which is ene kratke, and here o. So what do we get? We get ka at the end. And how do we form the comparative degree from the adjectives or adverbs which has ka ending? We change ka into cha and add the suffix ye. So this is what we get as the comparative degree. Gromche. So ka has been changed to cha and we have added the suffix ye. Gromki, gromka, gromche. So next consonant alternation that we'll be talking about is G changes to R. G changes to R. For example, let's take this adjective daragoi. What is daragoi? Daragoi is dear or expensive. And the adjective is daragoi and the adverb is doraga. Doraga again is an adverb. And so how do we form the comparative degree? We do the same thing. We drop the ending, which is O ikratke in the adjective and O in the adverb, and then we are supposed to change the last consonant, which is G, into R and add the suffix ye. So daroshe. So this is what we get as the comparative degree from the adjective daragoi or from the adverb doraga. Daragoi, doraga, daroshe. Next consonant alternation that takes place while forming the comparative degree is kh changes to sh. For example, let's take the adjective tikhi. Tikhi is silent. The adverb that is derived from the adjective is tikha. And how do we form the comparative degree? Change this kh to sh and add the suffix ye. Tishe. Tikhi, tikha, and tishe. The next alternation that we'll be discussing is when the consonant t changes to ch. For example, bagati. Bagati is rich. And there is no corresponding adverb from this adjective. So we'll try to form the comparative degree from this adverb. So how do we do this? We just drop the ending, which is I and I kratke here, and change this T into CH and add the suffix ye. So what do we get? We get bagache. So these are some of the alternations. Some more are there that we'll discuss in the next part. Apart from the alternation of consonants while forming the comparative degree, there are some more alternation of consonants that happens while forming the comparative degree. So let's discuss about them one by one. The next alternation of consonant that we are going to discuss is when the consonant the changes to the consonant zh. For example, maladoi. Maladoi means young. So this is the adjective, and what comparative degree do we derive from this adjective? Maloshe. So what have we done? We have dropped the ending, which is O and E kratke, and we have changed the consonant the into zh, and this is how we got maloshe. Maloshe is younger. The next with the same alternation is tyordi. What is tyordi? Tyordi is hard. For example, we have already discussed about this word while discussing tyordi's nak, which is hard sign. So how do we form the comparative degree from this adjective? We do the same thing. Drop the ending, which is I and I kratke, and change the consonant the into je and add the suffix ye. So what do we get? Tyorje. Tyorje, harder. The next alternation of consonants is when the adjective or the adverb ends with a cluster of consonants s and th. So, this consonant cluster changes to one consonant which is sh. For example, chisti. What is chisti? Chisti is clean. And the adverb that we derive from this adjective is chista. So, how do we form the comparative degree from either the adjective or the adverb? We drop the ending, and as you can see, the stem ends with the consonant cluster s and th together. So, as we have already told you that we have to change this consonant cluster to sh. Chishe. Chishe is the comparative degree derived from the adjective chisti or chista, which is the adverb. Chishe is cleaner. The next example from the same alternation of consonants is tolsti. What is tolsti? Tolsti is fat. So, how do we form the comparative degree? Tolshe. Tolshe is fatter. The next example is prastoi. Prastoi is simple. And the adverb that is derived from prastoi is prosta. So, what about the comparative degree? How will we derive the comparative degree? Proshe. So, we are doing the same thing. We are changing the consonant cluster into sh. Proshe. Apart from these alternation of consonants, there is one more alternation, but in this kind of alternation, we are not changing the consonant which is there, but we are adding another consonant. For example, if the stem ends with v, then we are adding, we are supposed to add an additional consonant which is l. For example, jishovi. Jishovi is less expensive or cheap. The adverb derived from this adjective is joshava. Jishovi joshava. So, how do we get the comparative degree from this adjective or adverb? Jishevlie. Jishevlie, as you can see, what we are doing is we are adding an additional consonant l and then we are adding the suffix ye. Jishevlie. Jishevlie is, what is jishevlie? Cheaper. So, this is how we get or how do we form the comparative degree either from an adjective or from an adverb. So, there are a couple of rules also which we will be discussing in the next part. The comparative degree of an adjective or an adverb is also formed by adding the suffix she to the stem, sh and ye. For example, if we take the adjective stary, which means old, we get starshe. So, we drop the ending ne kratke and add she to the stem to get its comparative degree. Stary, starshe, older. Dolgi, dolgi which means long, the adverb derived from this adjective is dolga. So, what do we get as its comparative degree? Dolshe. L and soft sign, dolshe. Dalyoki, dalyoki is far. Dalyoki, daliko, which is the adverb derived from the adjective dalyoki. Dalshe. So, this is how we form the comparative degree from the adjective dalyoki or the adverb daliko, dalshe. The next is rani. Rani is early. The adverb from this adjective is rana. Again, early. And the comparative degree that is derived from the adjective rani or the adverb rana is ranshe, earlier. Apart from the rules that we follow while forming the comparative degree, there are some irregular formations also. For example, the adjective balshoi has the comparative degree bolshe. The adverb mala has the comparative degree menshe. The adjective malinki, which means small, has the comparative degree menshe, like mala. And the adverb mnoga, which means a lot, has the comparative degree bolshe, like balshoi. Apart from these irregular comparative degree, there's some other comparative degree which are irregular too. For example, kharoshi, the comparative degree of kharoshi, which is good, is lushe, which is better. And the comparative degree of the adjective plakhoi, which means bad, is huje, which means worse. So, this is all about the formation of the comparative degree from an adjective or an adverb. So, now the question comes, how do we use the comparative degree in a sentence? So, there are two ways which we can use the comparative degree in a sentence. The first one is by using the nominative case of the noun with which something is compared, preceded by the word chiem. So, let me repeat. We can use the comparative degree with the nominative case of the noun preceded by the word chiem. And you have to remember that chiem, before chiem, we have to put a comma. So, for example, etat dom krasivye chiem tot dom. So, here as you can see, we are comparing two houses, this house and that house. How have you used the comparative degree? We have used the nominative case of the other noun with which the first noun is being compared plus chiem. And as you can see, we have put a comma here after the comparative degree. So, this house is more beautiful than the other house or that house. And the other variant with which we can use the comparative degree in a sentence is by using the genitive case of the noun with which something is compared. For example, etat gorat starshe. So, this city is older. Tavo gorada, as you can see, tavo gorada is in the genitive case. So, after the comparative degree, we are supposed to use the genitive case of the noun with which something is compared. So, these are two ways in which we can use the comparative degree of an adjective or an adverb. So, let's move on to our next topic. So, the next topic that we are going to discuss is the collective numerals. So, how do you understand this term, collective numerals? Collective numerals are the numbers which are used to denote a collection or group of person or objects as a whole. For example, dvoye malchikov, troye malchikov, dvoye studentov, and so on. So, two students, two boys, and so on. And here I would like to mention that there are not many collective numerals in Russian language, and many of them have been derived from the cardinal numbers. For example, from 2, which is a cardinal number, we derive the collective numeral dvoye. Likewise, from 3, we derive the collective numeral troye. From 4, chetvera. From 5, pyatera. From 6, shestera. From 7, siemera. From 8, vosmera. From 9, devichera. And from 10, desichera. One more important thing to mention here is 8, 9 and 10. So, the collective numerals derived from the cardinal numbers 8, 9 and 10 are very less used in Russian. All the other numbers are used more or less frequently. Other than the numbers, the collective numerals derived from the cardinal numbers, there are other collective numerals also. For example, oba or obe. Oba is used with the masculine nouns and obe is used with the feminine nouns. So, when we use a noun with the collective numerals which are derived from the cardinal numbers, we use the genitive case of the nouns. While when we use the nouns with the collective numeral oba or obe, we use the genitive singular form of the noun. So, this is the difference between these two group of collective numerals. So, here with doe, troe, chetvera, pyachera, shescera, siemera, vosmera, we will use the genitive plural form of the noun, while with oba and obe, we will use the genitive singular. For example, obas tujyanta, obis tujyantki. So, both the students, female students, oba means both. So, now the question comes, how do we use the collective numerals in a sentence, or to denote what we use the collective numerals? So, the collective numerals are used with animate masculine nouns. So, apart from this obe, collective numerals are always used with animate masculine nouns. For example, dvoistujyantav, two students, troist malchikav, three boys. So, here as you can see, the nouns which we have used are masculine nouns. So, here you cannot use feminine nouns with the collective numerals doe and troe. The other use is to denote young animals. So, collective numerals are used to denote the young animals or small animals or the offsprings of an animal. For example, doe shinyat, shinyat is puppies. So, two puppies, troe kathyat, three kittens. So, to denote the young animals, we can use the collective numerals to denote the quantity of the persons which are masculine nouns plus young animals. And the third use is with inanimate nouns which do not have plurals. So, there are certain nouns which do not have their plurals because their form is itself plural. For example, troe sutak is three night and day. So, sutak here means 24 hours. Troe sutak, doe chisof, chissi as you know does not have any plural, chissi is watch. So, two watches. So, these are some of the uses of the collective numerals in Russian. One more important thing about the collective numerals is that only in the nominative case their use is preferred. In all the other oblique cases, the cardinal numbers are preferred to denote the quantity of the nouns. And one more thing is, the collective numerals also change their forms in various cases. So, they also decline in the various cases. So, while using them, you have to be careful about their forms. So, this is about the collective numerals in Russian. So, this is all we have learned in this lesson. So, what all we have learned? We have learned the comparative degree of adjectives and adverbs, which are derived only from the qualitative adjectives or adverb, and we have discussed about the collective numerals. So, this is all for today. So, we will meet in the next lesson. Till then, dasvidaniya, spasiba.